Hi, in this video of C programming language, we will discuss about a void data type. As in the previous video of data types, we have discussed like when there is no value, we will use void data type. So that is what it means. So basically, whenever you are defining a function in which you're not returning anything, you can mark the return type as void. Similarly, if you don't want to pass any parameter while making a method call, you can pass the void as well. But even if you will not pass anything, by default, it will be void. Similarly, by the time we will start working with pointers, we will see what is a void pointer. Basically, it can store the address of any type of value, but you will not be able to do any arithmetic. But we will discuss about such things in a great detail in a coming videos when we will discuss about the pointers. So now, as I said in the previous video as well, you cannot define a variable of void type. So this one is an invalid statement. Now, let's see how to use the void as a return type. So here, as you can see, in int main, if I'm specifying like the return type of a function is int, at the end, I'm returning a zero from the method. But if I will say void main means I don't want to return anything, and at the end you can see like I have just used return. Even if I want to skip, I can do that if it is a last statement. But even after the return keyword, as you can see here, I have not specified any particular value of any particular type. So this is how this void works. So let's see an example quickly to compare the functionality of a void and a non-void return type of any function. So as here you can see, like right now I have written a main method where the return type is integer. So at the end you can observe like here I have passed the value called 0. Since this main method is returning an integer, so every time when I will execute this particular program, you can see this is main returning an integer. That's the message I printed, and here you can also observe the return value is 0. But as I said, if I'll use void, I will not be allowed to pass any type of value during the return. So if I'll execute it now, all right, here you can see like it is returning 25. But here you can also see like it's returning a warning. So I will just remove this particular value from here. And now I'll not specify any kind of value. Return can be used in any particular program in order to terminate the function. But now when I will execute, you see there is no warning, no errors are there, and still it is returning 25. So this value is not now in our control. So whenever you want to control the value that is returned by a method, you will use the data type, that particular return type out here, except void. And then after return, you will pass the value of that specific data type as well.